Hello, welcome back to Artificial Intelligent Winter Program. My name is Tommy, and this is our first part of my course. The topic is about Anaconda, Colab, and Python. And in this part, we will learn how to install Anaconda in our local computer and know how to use Google account to log in to Colab and use Colab. Both platforms are for Python. Anaconda is installed in the local computer, so you can bring your computer to anywhere, and then you can use your computer without internet to write your Python code and execute it. However, in Anaconda, you need to install packages or other libraries by yourself. Sometimes the packages have the collision or have some version problem, so it is not an easy thing to fix them. On the other hand, Colab is created, prepared by Google, so Colab didn't have the problem about the package and the library installation, since Google had fixed them. So we just use them and execute our Python code. However, because the Colab is a cloud platform, so when we want to use Colab, we need internet. Therefore, which platform do you want to use? That is dependent on you. You can choose Colab to use or Anaconda to use. Both are okay. For me, I use both of platform. When I have no internet, I will use Anaconda. And I have internet, and the internet speed is not very slow. I will use Colab. Okay. Maybe you can use ways like me. After introduce the Anaconda and the Colab, we will take about 5 minutes or 10 minutes break, and then we will briefly introduce the common commands in Python, and then you can use these commands to write your first program in Python. And in our course, we will have some question or some practice for you, and you can use about 5 minutes or 10 minutes to practice by yourself, and then I will give the reference answer, and you can see how to solve the practice and questions. Okay, and let me begin and start our topic about Anaconda, Colab, and Python. This is the course outline of this today, 6 hours. The first day is today, and we will see the Anaconda, Colab, and Python. And next day, we will see the data science with Pandas, NumPy, and other packages. Okay, this is our first part about the Anaconda, Colab, and the Python. We will introduce Anaconda and the Colab, and I will operate them to you first, and then we will have 5 minutes to try it, and then we will introduce Python's commands and do some practice and see their answers. Okay, let's start. In many years ago, if you want to install Python in your local computer or laptop, you need to install at least following software or tools and packages by yourself. Like you need to go to the website of Python and download the Python and install it, and then go to Anaconda, download it, and install it, and so on. TensorFlow, Keras, NumPy, SciPy, Pandas, and MemPyLab. And this is will take you a lot of time to install it and solve the install problems, because every local computer is different. So in the past, when the engineering or a programmer wants to install Python and its related software, it is a difficult job. However, in these 2 or 3 years, Anaconda summarize the all software, and it is a big software. That means you just install Anaconda, and Anaconda will automatically install Python and the other general package and the libraries in your local computers. So if you want to use local computer to write your Python code and the program, you may consider use Anaconda to your platform. Okay, and let me see how to download the Anaconda from the Anaconda website. First, you can use the search engine to search Anaconda, and then you can see the Anaconda's official website. Then you click it, and then you can see this is the homepage of Anaconda, and you can get the start here. Okay, and you can see all Anaconda products. There are 3 products here: individual, teams, enterprise version. And the individual version is free, so you can use it. And in the following course, I will use the local computer Anaconda to show our programs. Okay, and if you want to download individual version, you just click here, learn more, and then download it. Okay, and here are 3 versions for the different operation systems: Windows, macOS, and Linux. And we will use Windows for our example. Okay, you download this one, 64-bit installer. And this is because most of Windows are 64-bit right now. Okay. After you download it, you will get this one installer, and then you double click it to install it. When you see this window, that means you will begin to install Anaconda. Okay. And install Anaconda, it is very easy. You just follow its step, like click the next, and then I agree. And then you can just for me, or if you have others user, you also you can click all users. Both one are okay for the installation, okay, which is just me. And then you can change the installation folder. The default folder is in user and your account and Anaconda. And if you want to install to other folder, you just to here to browse and change it and change it. Okay, and then you can click the next. Okay, for this, it is not recommend to add Anaconda to the whole environment. This means Anaconda will change your Windows path and to build a short path to Anaconda. So in his note, it also says not recommend. If you click it, it will change the color to red. Of course, if you think Anaconda change your computer's path, that is fine and you can click it. But I suggest do not click it. Okay. And this is need to click because this is the default for the Python, and the stable Python version is 3.7. And in my computer, I have installed Anaconda 3. So when I click it, it will show this warning. Okay. So I will cancel it. And after you click it, you can click install, and it will take some time to install Anaconda, Python, and its related software and packages. Okay. And we skip this installation because I have installed it. After installing Anaconda, you can click start in Windows and find the Anaconda folder like this one, Anaconda 3, 64-bit. And you click the folder, it will show the Anaconda here. Okay. If you click the Jupyter Notebook here, and it will create the Python platform, and you can write your code in here. Okay, for this one, if you click the Jupyter Notebook, and it will jump a command windows, and it will say it is starting the Anaconda and the Jupyter Notebook. And then it will show this window. You can just click Google Chrome for the default browser to open the Jupyter Notebook. However, some computer may not show this automatic windows. That means some computer execute the commands and then it will stop here. And if your computer meet this situation, you need to click the browser like the Chrome, and I suggest you to use Chrome for open a new Windows. Like this one, you need to click a new Chrome Windows by yourself, and then you copy this line or the following line, just choose one and copy it and paste on your Chrome browser, and then the Chrome browser will open the Jupyter Notebook here. Of course, if your computer execute the commands and then it show up the Windows automatically, you can just click the Chrome and to open the page like this. In Anaconda, the default page is in your computer, and you can click the folder to change your storage folder. For example, I want to store my Python file in my desktop, and I just click the desktop. And then if I want to use a folder especially to store the Python code, I can use this new and the folder, this one, or you can change its names like this one, click it and rename it, and you can rename it like the Python code. Okay, and then you click your folder, and then your Python code will store in this folder. And it is easy to create a new Python file like this one. You click new and Python 3, and it will load it, and then you can see the Jupyter Notebook here, and here you can type your code in this block, and then you can execute it and see the result. For example, if we want to print hello here, we just in this green block and type print. This means the Python will print a seems by print command. Okay. And then if we want to print hello, and we can use print and then use quotation mark and to type hello this string. Like this one. And then you want to execute this command, you just click this run, and then it will show the result in the following block. Okay, you can see it will print hello everyone in the following blocks. And then this block, you can type a new Python code here, and you can execute by run and so on. And if you want to rename your file's name, because when you create a new Python file, it will use untitled for his name, and you can click here, and maybe this will be our first Python code. First Python code. Okay. And it will rename your files. And this is the Anaconda's and its Jupyter Notebook for your local computer's Python platform. And if you want to know how many packages are installed in Anaconda, you can click Start Anaconda and click this Navigator, and it will show how many packages and libraries are also installed by Anaconda. It will depend on your computer's power. If your computer is very powerful, and the Navigator will show very quickly. Okay, here is the Navigator. And also, you can execute Jupyter Notebook by this command launch, and it also will show the Jupyter Notebook platform. And if you want to see the packages in your Anaconda, you can click Environments here. And here is the installed packages and libraries. For example, like Python, it is installed automatically, like this Python, and its version is 3.7.6. And the common package are also installed, like Pandas. Pandas is a package to handle the tables, especially for the very very large tables. And you can see the NumPy, and NumPy is handle for area or lists. And you can see the matplotlib. Matplotlib is for the drawing figures by Python. Okay. And so on. You can use the search engine to see what this package works and what it can do. Let me back to our slides. Okay. And you see this TensorFlow, Keras, SciPy are also installed in the local computers by Anaconda. Okay. And this is the reference for top 20 Python libraries for data science in 2 years ago. If you have interest, you can click this link and you can see the contents in this web. Okay, and if you don't want to use Anaconda in your local computer, or your local computer is not very powerful to execute the Anaconda, another way is to use cloud version like the CoLab or Kaggle. And here we introduce CoLab for our cloud version. This is the CoLab link. You can click it directly to the CoLab website. And then you can see the CoLab website like this one. And if you don't want to remember the link of CoLab, you can search by search engine. You type CoLab and search engine will show the Google CoLab here, and you click this link, you can enter to the CoLab. Okay, let me change it to the English version. If you want to use CoLab you need to have a Google account. You need a Google account. If you don't have a Google account, you can create one later by our practice time. And you can, if you have a Google account here, you can click sign in and type your account ID. And this ID is from testing. So I type it, and then the password. And if you have two-step verification, you need to type the verification code here. And two-step verification can enhance and increase the security. So if you need to protect your Google account carefully, and you can apply two-step verification. After you enter, sign in your Google account, you can type your code here, or you can click File to create a new notebook. When you create a new notebook, and it will be empty, and you can see that your notebook is very similar to Anaconda, this one. You can see that this is the Jupyter notebook by Anaconda, and this block is similar to Colab block. And you can type here, and like for print. I copy this command to Colab. Okay, like this one, and then you just click here to run this commands. When you click this one, the Colab website will connect to the data center by Google, and then Google the data center will patch you the cloud region RAM and disk, and then after connected, it will run this command, and the output is here. You will see that hello everyone. It is same as Jupyter notebook. So if you know how to write Python and execute Python in Jupyter notebook or Colab, and then you can also know how to use other platform like Kaggle or other Python cloud version platform. And in Colab or Jupyter notebook, the platform will automatically save your code like this one. When it said auto-saved, that means Jupyter notebook has saved your code in your folder. And here, if Colab shows all changes saved, that means it saved it your code to the Google Drive. And that means if you click here to change your file name, like this one, first Python code. Okay, and then you can go to the Google Drive. Okay, let me click one to show our Google Drive. Okay, here, and you can see our first will be here, Google Drive here. You can see that here, first Python code here. And this means when you create a new Python file, and in your Google Drive, Colab notebooks folder, it automatically create your new Python file here, and you can click here and download. Of course, you can use Google Drive to store other Python code, and then you just click it and click the right button in your mouse, and you can choose the tool by Google Colab, and then it will open a new window to show your Python code like this. Okay, and this is the introduction to the Colab. And then we will have a practice time, and for 5 minutes, you can install Anaconda in your local computer, or you can log in to the cloud version like a Colab. And if you don't have a Google account, and please create one. And after you install Anaconda or log in to the Colab, you can try some Python code if you have learned it. And if you don't have learned Python before, you can type print hello like I showed before. And this is our practice. And you choose what? So install Anaconda or log in to Colab. And then type print hello for our practice. And after 5 minutes, we will see the common commands in Python. Hope you will like this course. Thank you.